Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about blind SQL injection vulnerabilities. So let's get started. Injection flaws allow adversaries to inject untrusted data into a system or application through a malicious query command. The malicious code is typically used to compromise both the application's clients and backend systems. This article explains a blind SQL injection flaw, various types of attacks, and best practices to prevent them. What is SQL injection? The SQL injection vulnerability enables attackers to send malicious input to an application by modifying database queries. By exploiting SQL flaws, hackers can manipulate the application's backend using malicious statements that control its database server. Therefore, the hackers can access all the database contents or bypass application security checks using SQL injection vulnerabilities. Adversaries can also use dangerous SQL queries to delete, modify, or add remote database records, thus impacting the credibility of data processed by the vulnerable web application. The hacker must scan the application for user input interfaces vulnerable to injection to perform an SQL injection attack. They then create a malicious payload using SQL statements to be executed by the application's database. Besides accessing data tables and user credentials, attackers can craft malicious SQL queries to access the OAuths using the database server. SQL injection is one of the oldest, most prevalent, and most dangerous web vulnerabilities. It affects any application or website that relies on a relational SQL database, such as the SQL server. SQL injection attacks can be of several types. These include in-band SQL attacks, out-of-band SQL attacks, blind SQL attacks. This is a type of SQL injection attack in which the adversary sends malicious queries to the server and then uses its response to make inferences about the application's configuration. Blind SQL attacks are mainly performed on websites vulnerable to SQL injection and show generic information for each error message. This type of attack is known as blind inferential SQL. The server does not output the queried data on the attacker's web interface, so they employ a series of follow-up queries to infer its response and behavioral patterns. Since the HTTP response of the database server typically lacks details of database errors or relevant SQL query results, blind SQL attacks are challenging to perform but possible. Blind SQL attacks are primarily categorized into Boolean content-based blind SQL injection attacks. This blind SQL attack involves testing the database server for vulnerabilities by crafting queries that ask the database true or false objective type questions. An attacker then checks whether each query modifies the information within the HTTP response to make inferences about the database schema and server's configuration. Time-based SQL injection attacks. In a time-based attack, hackers craft an SQL command that forces the server to wait a certain period before responding. They send this database query to the server and observe how long it takes to respond. Depending on whether the response was sent instantly or after a while, the hacker will determine whether the malicious queries were true or false statements without relying on any data transmitted by the server. This attack involves a time-intensive operation as each database entry must be enumerated character by character. Any application with SQL injection vulnerabilities is susceptible to blind SQL injection attacks. This section describes how to protect against blind SQL injection attacks on modern websites and web applications. Parameterize SQL statements. A parameterized query is a pre-made SQL statement such that the user only needs to supply values parameters into the statement for the database to execute. Developers should parameterize all dynamic query user input, enabling strict and robust controls on which queries the database should run. Besides preventing injection attacks, parameterized queries, prepared statements, allow the database to execute the same statement multiple times without compiling, parsing, or optimizing. This improves the database server response times, improving application efficiency. Utilize secure coding practices. Use your chosen web platform's inbuilt injection prevention mechanisms to protect the application against blind SQL attacks. The OWASP SQL injection cheat sheet includes multiple prevention and mitigation measures for blind SQL flaws. Developers should ensure proper input validation at query input locations. Additionally, in database systems that support stored procedures, developers can use them to define expected queries, avoiding malicious user-controllable inputs. Filtering and escaping special characters for all database inputs ensures the server only executes allowed queries. An often overlooked best practice is avoiding generic error messages, which may provide information for the hacker's arbitrary code. Use an automated vulnerability scanner. An automatic vulnerability scanner helps cross-functional teams identify injection gaps within a web application before hackers can exploit them through continuous autonomous testing. The Crashtest Security Suite includes a vulnerability scanner that scans single and multi-page web applications and APIs to eliminate security blind spots with few false positives and negatives. The scanner continuously benchmarks the website's security posture against the OWASP Top 10, allowing security teams to detect and remediate injection flaws as they emerge throughout the SDLC. Why is it important for your business? It is vital to prevent blind SQL vulnerabilities as they grant attackers access to a vulnerable application's database, which can have significant consequences. These include theft of sensitive client data such as credit card details and other personally identifying information, executing administrative commands through database manipulation, application unavailability due to modified or missing underlying database records. Database fingerprinting allows the attacker to identify the recipients of data. Password enumeration using time-based blind SQL injection. Time-based attacks are highly dependent on the type of database being accessed. With such attacks, attackers can craft a statement that enumerates user passwords using logic similar to: if the first letter is an A, wait 10 seconds. If the first letter is a B, wait 15 seconds, and so on. The attacker may use a SQL query, such as the code shown in the video, combined with a time-taking operation such as benchmark, that delays the database's response if the expression is true. The hacker ensures that the benchmark operation specifies enough function repetitions to give the server a noticeable delay in response. This video shows that a 5-second delay can be achieved by executing the function 5 million times. The attacker then combines both queries. If there is a delay in database response time, then user ID 1's first password character is a 2. Attackers can use this method for the rest of the characters to enumerate all passwords in a database, compromising their accounts. Content-based attacks. Hackers commonly use Boolean attacks to uncover SQL vulnerabilities in an application. Assuming an e-commerce website displays items for sale, retrieved from a database server, with the URL shown in the video, where the SQL query used to access the resource and column names, include the code shown in the video. An attacker can supply the following malicious query to exploit the SQL vulnerability. This modifies the query to look like the code shown in the video. If this returns a false response with a list displaying no items, the attacker modifies the payload too. In this case, the SQL query will look similar to the code shown in the video. As the query returns the true value, the database displays the details of item 5 in its response. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.